strength. Hey, Hayaramas Karanas Karamano. Making us alive in you, Lord. Hey, we thank you today, God, for the victory. Thank you for the peace of God that passes all understanding. Thank you for the joy that fills my heart. Oh, God, we thank you. We rejoice in you. We give you the glory that's due your name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hey, Lala Bahasha. Praise your name. Praise your name. Praise your name. Praise your name.
Around, and we're thanking God for
I'll just look at that again. I'm proud of Thanksgiving and praise, look at page 31 and 32. I want you to read this time, because this is what we want to build our prayer around. Everybody may have a book. Everybody's reading this time. Hearts are reading that. Father, thank you for making a total provision. All the needs. Those who pass, those who die, those who yet to come. Gracious heart.
Being disposed to show everything. Administration of the Lord's heart, perception of care of the poor.
As a father who loves and pities his children, so does he love and pity those who fear you. You are my Lord,
the faithful God.
Verses have been God of all comforts.
And it is because of your kind nature and that of all mercies that we are so faithful and undying.
And I'm not so.
Great is your faithfulness.
Thank you and bless you.
All of your gifts.
You've forgiven all my iniquities. You've forgiven all my diseases.
You've redeemed my life from destruction.
Grounded me in loving kindness and tender mercies. You satisfied my mouth with good things,
fulfilled my youth with your divine beauty.
Father, all that you have done, guided us have come through our Lord Jesus Christ. This was your command before the beginning of time.
Christ, you will be laid on his life.
Before the world began, to the reason why you could be so gracious and show us these mercies and such great kindness which you see and feel through your in these names, your benevolent and compassionate heart, our Jesus. These names you have covered through your spirit to be the Lord. They are always with me. Jehovah. Let's say that again.
The Lord, they are always with me.
So we just want to keep this in mind. The Lord always, they are with me. Amen. The Lord is, the Lord my what?
Peace.
That's Jehovah alone. The Lord my provider.
Jehovah.
The Lord my banner. Captain of victory. Jehovah. Lord, my shepherd, the Lord, my righteousness, Jehovah, the Lord, my righteousness. Which one of them are you going to take? Which one do you like? Amen. Tell him you like them all.
Yes.
Lord, you are my peace. Lord, you. Hey! Lord, you are my provider.
Yes.
The Lord, you are my righteousness. Lord, you are my captain. In other words, you fight the battles for me.
Yes.
Hey, Lord, you are my what? Physician.
Yes.
Amen. These are things you can consistently remind God. As you remind him and release these things, even on a daily basis, God will begin to rise up. Amen. And begin to rain these different blessings and benefits down on you. To see the great benefits. All right, let's continue. Father, the things you have done for me have not been due to what I made, our good works which I perform, but because of your graciousness and kind nature. You are full of compassion, ready to forgive and plenteous in mercy. Because you delighted in mercy, you are ever looking from one end of the earth to another. Show yourself strong on the behalf of those whose hearts are trusting in the mind. Your desire to bless me and meet all my needs is more than I want to see my needs. Thank you for giving all of these things. Hey, come here. Thank you for your
that unspeakable one here. Yeah. Because all of these blessings are possible and were provided for us through Christ. So he's the unspeakable one. He deserves all of the glory. Amen. Praise God. Let's continue. Every good and every perfect gift come from above, coming down from the Father of lights, the moon is low there, and the shadow of time. He openeth yon hand, loadeth us with benefits, daily, satisfies the desire. Every day. Hey, hallelujah. For you, O Lord, over all, and is nigh and rich unto all that call upon you, to all that call upon you. You are not just willing to respond to my needs, but full of need. You are eagerly awaiting the opportunity to release your blessings on you in great profusion or abundance. It is when I receive, is that right? It is when I receive from you, and my prayers are answered, my need is met, that my glory is fulfilled. Your desire for me is that my joy, amen. Inasmuch as you did not spare your own son, but delivered him up for us all, it is evident enough for me to know that you are not a tight-fisted God who is in the business of withholding blessings from me. If you did not hold back your best and your son, you will not refuse. Give me or hold back the rest. Because Jesus was offered up for us all and have become our merciful and faithful God. Because of all blessings, has been made bigger. Hey, and the fountain of blessings has become full to overflow, causing your grace to be poured out and released into my life in great confusion. Father, I thank you. Bless you for your manifest mercies and for your abundance. I just want to give you a little. Here is that under grace, God's blessings have become more abundant because Christ has already consummated the plan of redemption and he has sent back the Holy Spirit to us. See, the Holy Spirit indwells us, so we have a whole lot more. God was able to do, is able to do a whole lot more under grace than he was able to do under the old covenant. Because now the Spirit comes in and he becomes everything that God is and was and will ever be. Amen. Because grace is the sum total of all that God has done for us. Everybody say it. It's the sum total of all that God has done for us. Christ. I want you to repeat that. Is the sum total of all that God has done for us through who? Christ. Okay, but it doesn't stop there. It's the sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ and that's now doing for us through the Holy Ghost. So we could really get a revelation of the Holy Ghost in us working the will and the do of his pleasure. Amen. We wouldn't mind releasing our prayer language because it's all in the prayer language. It's all, that's the way you let the Holy Ghost loose to do all that he has what? Been, amen, sent here to do. If we have the advantage of the Holy Ghost being in us, amen, David and all of those, amen, they had to, amen, and all of those, they had to depend on God, amen, from an external source. They had to hear a voice. Amen. God had to send a prophet and amen. Praise God. It was just certain places and then under certain conditions that you could receive these benefits. But yet, all of the benefits that God had for us were not available for us under the old covenant. But it's now available to us through the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Amen. That God has sent. Amen. And I want you to focus on the prayer, not now, the prayer that enables you, that helps to release your
prayer language in its fullness. Amen. Because if we could praise the Lord fully, if we could just totally release ourselves, and it has to be singing. The best way to release yourself fully and completely is going to be spontaneous singing. You're going to have to get so full of this until, amen, anointed songs and melodies are just going to what, flow from your mouth. Amen. And that's going to praise God, bring you to the realm of praise where God can fully release, amen, his fullness into your life. Now, what prayer is that? 44? But write it down. It's the prayer that deals with my prayer language. Is that number 34? So God is working now through the Holy Ghost. And he's your guide, he's your leader, he's your comforter. And if you don't yield to him, what number is that?
34.
No, it's my releasing my prayer. Amen. 45. So this week we want to get a full release of our prayer language. Amen. Full release. And that's going to lead to spontaneous singing. And you're going to be heard all over the church. It's going to go beyond silence and quietness and tone down to a real breakthrough in singing. Amen. And praying loud, spontaneously in the spirit. So that's the prayer language, because these blessings are going to be consummated through your release in your prayer language. Amen. That's the thing that's holding us back. Our prayer language is a little, we need to work on it, and we need to lift up our voices, and we need a major breakthrough. All of us who do that, we will see the glory of God in a new dimension. Amen. Before this week is over, I'm done. Hallelujah. Tomorrow night, I got a special message. Amen. That's focusing on praying and begin to reach out to others, because God is merciful. The Bible says, blessed are the merciful. If we want more mercy, if we want more compassion release, if we want more benefits released in our life, then we got to be merciful too. If we are merciful, we want to make an effort this week to everybody to be responsible for getting two or three people here Sunday. We've got to really begin to work at reaching out and being concerned about people. Amen. This is going to be our focus this week. We've got to get, because God is going to get us, amen, on cloud 13, but it's not just for us to come here to have a good time. Amen. God speaks a lot about those that have compassion on others. If you really want the big blessing, if you want your joy to go way, way up, amen, you begin to focus on others. Amen. Come and get what you need. Amen. It's what we want you to do now, but it ain't going to take forever. Amen. Let's go on and, amen, get out of breakthrough. Yes. And then use that overflow to begin to minister and to bring others into the kingdom.
Yes.
And we're also going to be focusing on start taking care of people that God has in the midst. We're going to have to spend more time in dealing with people. Amen. And not just let them come in and go. Come in and go and do what they want to do. Amen. So this week, we're going to be focusing on compassion. But it's not just going to be compassion to make us feel better and to help us to receive all these mercies and blessings. Mm-hmm. But it's going to be for us to begin to share the love of God, the blessings of God.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God with others. Amen. That's the objective of all that we're doing. Amen. God.